Good morning from NASA's Johnson Space Center. This is Mission Control Houston, Tuesday, March 13th, 2012. You're looking at the International Space Station Flight Control Room from the back of the room, looking over the shoulders of a team of flight controllers, each monitoring different systems aboard the International Space Station. As this team has been on console since earlier this morning, about 7 a.m. Central Time, led today once again by veteran Flight Director Royce Renfrew. He's overseeing this team throughout the morning and early afternoon. He's joined on console by Josh Matthew, who's serving as the spacecraft communicator, the CAPCOM for the team. He basically relays information from the team to the crew on board the International Space Station. That orbiting complex just about to move into an orbital sunset as it tracks off the southern tip of Madagascar, having made a swing across Central Africa just a little while ago. The space station from this altitude will move into a sunset in about 10 minutes. That'll be about a 14-minute period of time where the station's in darkness, circling the Earth every 92 minutes from this vantage point of 242 miles above the Earth. On board is the Expedition 30 crew of the International Space Station, headed by Commander Dan Burbank. You see him in the seated in the front left of the view. He and two of his crewmates, Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin, Russian cosmonauts, have been on board the station for 120 days. They've been in space now for 122 days since their launch on a Soyuz rocket back on November 13th of 2011. They arrived at the station on Wednesday, November 16th. The other three crew members that make up the Expedition 30 crew arrived a little bit later. Oleg Kononenko, Russian cosmonaut, serving as the commander of the 29 Soyuz spacecraft, launched with his fellow crewmates, one from the Netherlands, Andre Kuipers, and U.S. astronaut Don Pettit. Those three arrived at the station back on Friday, December 23rd, 2011, after their launch December 21st. They now are enjoying their 82nd day aboard the International Space Station, and they've been in space now for 84 days. The six crew members wake up each day about 1 in the morning, U.S. Central Time. That's at 0600 GMT. They check the station out, do a morning inspection, and then have breakfast, all of that between wake-up time and 2 a.m. After that, they head off and prepare for their work day based on their timeline, and then hold a daily planning conference with the teams on the ground. And then after that, they head off in different directions, and Dan Burbank has focused all of his attention pretty much for the day on working with the extravehicular mobility units, the EMUs or spacesuits in the space station's Quest airlock, swapping those suits out. And he's also doing a number of checkouts to ensure those suits are in good working order in the event that they are called into duty for any spacewalk that's required outside the space station by the crew members. Additionally, in the U.S. Laboratory Destiny, astronaut Don Pettit has spent a good deal of his day working with the Robonaut humanoid in the U.S. Laboratory Destiny, and he's got more work to do throughout the day to run some additional tests with Robonaut, and that will include a handshake as part of the systems checkouts that are ongoing periodically with Robonaut 2 there housed in the U.S. Laboratory Destiny. Additionally, maintenance activities ongoing with the environmental control and life support system on the station, and the Russian colleagues aboard the complex are working back in the Russian segment on experiments and maintenance activities as well as life aboard the International Space Station continues for all six crew members that make up the Expedition 30 crew of the International Space Station.